I was never suspended, not even for an hour. I don't know what the issue of suspension in Swakai. I did respond to some of the inquiries from some of you. However, nobody could believe me. So that is why probably the PSP decided or now confirmed or like suspended. How will the PSP? Who else can satisfy your inquiry? So just to confirm that I was never suspended. We are identifying some of the officers that are corrupt. Notwithstanding, I think comparatively, the level of corruption in Botswana, particularly for Botswana Police Service, is very, very insignificant. However, corruption is cancerous. Even if it was just one or two cases, we need to make sure that we get rid of such behaviors. The unfortunate part, we will never win the war against corruption. If it is respectable members of the communities that are taking advantage of junior officers for that matter, to entice them to accept the bribes. I may dismiss officers as much as I can. If communities are not taking responsibility to fight crime, to assist us, we will continuously be dismissing people. So all that I'm asking is that in most of the cases, it is officers that are being enticed to receive bribes. Those that have been that extort. This is our country, this is our police service. If we corrupt the police service, then we can forget about the welfare of the nation at large.
Taking a young person who has not yet completed a school and employing them to be farm laborers was amounting to human trafficking. But that is the truth. So we need to educate our people first. But of course it is true, Botswana is also used as a transit for people who are being trafficked to other countries. And we can't be in denial that even some of our citizens have been trafficked to other countries. So it is still something that is not well understood by many people, but the truth is it is there. Once we increase public education, I think a lot more information might be coming our way, mainly because people will now be more aware than it is currently.